All right, Ben Simino, Teresa Priolo in for Greg and Rosanna. Let's get right to Jungle
Bob,
though,
over.
Because he's here. You're moving over?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, right. Yeah. Move it on over.
So how these things don't bite, right?
Good morning. Good to see you.
Good to see everybody.
Good to see
Thanks for having us
Thanks
on.
Thanks for coming on. Good
all
day.
Right, we met Castro, the iguana from Cuba.
Yep.
About 15, 20 minutes ago. Who do you have for us?
Well, we brought a few of our little friends out from our Jungle Bob's Reptile World out in Center Reach, where we have a really exotic pet store, but we have a huge organization that also does education. So we're here today to educate you and dispel some of the myths about some of these creepy crawly creatures.
Okay.
And first the first up. One, certainly the one that topped the list of creepy crawlies. You ready?
Yeah.
Is this the tarantula?
I think this is why Rosanna took off, actually.
Probably.
I'm kind of wondering why I didn't
wait.
Ask for
certainly
a vacation.
Certainly is a tarantula.
Can I hold this guy? I actually can't wait.
Okay, here we go. This is Rosie. She's a rose-haired tarantula
wow.
from the country of Chile. And there's so many myths about spiders, right? Arachnophobia is out there. Everybody's afraid of these things. But usually it's what you learn in life, to be afraid of these. And there's really nothing to fear, particularly on this species, which is one of the most docile creatures.
What is that?
Check that. What's going on there?
Oh, she's spinning a web.
Is that her web?
She's spinning a web.
Wow.
Can you see that? Can you guys see that?
I don't think you can see that, but there's
yeah,
some
it's
long
a little bit tight
coming out here. She is going right
they
up
spin
the
a web
arm.
Out of their abdomen, which you always see around the corners of your house in the living room, right? Had those cobwebs get up in the corner. She's heading right for your jugular vein.
They
where
can,
usually
they
go.
Can see
no, that's
some
the
of
myth
them.
That they're going to go do something
so
evil.
So why do they have that? Why do they have that reputation?
It's.
Can I pet her? I don't
she's
know.
She's actually very soft. You try hold her.
Petting is not the best thing. But
I mean,
certainly,
I like dogs and cats.
Yes.
We love dogs and cats.
See,
yes.
Soft.
But there's nothing wrong with these animals.
Wait a
there's
second. This, and she does not bite. She will not bite me.
Well, it is a venomous spider.
That's the thing.
It
so,
does have the
Oh, yeah.
It does
mention
have
that
fangs.
As you get to me.
The fangs are on the underside here, so it's right where your thumb is.
Uh-huh.
This is where the fangs are. But they're not going to defend themselves in that way. They want to bite their food.
If you are bitten by one of these spiders,
can
is it
that?
Lethal?
No. There's no such thing really as a lethal tarantula unless you have to have some kind of allergic reaction to the venom.
Okay.
There's lethal scorpions. There's lethal spiders like black widows and funnel webs that can have a very toxic bite, but the tarantula family, the large spiders, are pretty docile and not aggressive.
It's pretty cool.
Not every single one. Now I want to qualify that. This is a rose hair. I mean, we put 8 of these under people's Christmas trees.
She doesn't
this year.
Want to move. I this paralyzed her.
Yeah, they're just kind of chill. It really looks.
Does that
nice.
Mean she likes me or doesn't like
if
me?
If I could be so bold, it makes a beautiful brooch.
I don't know how I feel about that.
I'm with you here. Jungle Bob's here.
Yeah, Jungle Bob, do you have insurance?
We are fully insured, yes. And she'll just stay there the rest of the show. She's going to do a little web on you. That's okay.
Wow.
I
this is like cutting your teeth.
Listen,
you
lady.
You hang on to Rosie. Who else do we
Rosie,
have?
I have that there.
You and I got to make a
if
deal
we can move
here.
This a little bit here, we got
yeah,
a very, very
these.
Interesting.
She'll actually stay on
She'll stay right there.
If
you just stay calm. Anything goes wrong, yell out for Dylan. He's here to help you. Okay? A very, very cool amphibian. Now, here's amphibians a lot, the slimy animals, the newts, the salamanders, the toads.
You've got a frog for us, right?
And, of course, the frog. So people are afraid of frogs? Usually
wow,
not,
this
right?
This is a huge frog, though.
There's a frog. There's a frog.
Wow.
I don't know why I signed up for this.
That'll teach you. This is Jabba. He's one of our favorites.
Can I hold
it's
Jabba?
An African bullfrog.
Oh, interesting. I mean, it is.
And look at the smiles now. Everybody always smiles when frogs come out because frogs are non-threatening animals, right?
They are.
No one ever got hurt by a frog, right?
Oh, his skin is so cool.
Very cool.
Very
he's
cool.
been dried off a little bit. Normally, they're laying in the water in the African marshlands waiting for their food to come by. And you know what frogs eat, right?
Insects.
Flies. Yeah. Every book you ever see, frogs eat flies. Well, my travels, 17 countries, I'm not up there in Lee's status yet as far as countries visited, but we go looking for animals in the wild, and we saw these in Botswana and the Kalahari Desert in Africa, and they eat anything that moves. They eat anything that comes near them. Matter of fact, you want to put him down here,
sure.
He might be ready for...
Will he ribbit?
He does make a large, he's a male, so he does make a croaking sound.
Kind of feels like
but
silly
But it's party. Kind of interesting sometimes if he is.
Oh, those are worms. Oh,
those are caterpillars, actually.
Those are live.
Those are live. You could have those one of those, too, Teresa.
I've got my fill.
And sometimes he eats. It's a little cool in the studio here. Being a cold-blooded animal, sometimes he'll eat, sometimes he won't.
Look at that. Can you guys see these?
Yeah. These are little bugs that actually, if you grow tomatoes in your backyard, they're tomato hornworms. They're the ones that eat your tomato plants.
You don't
so
want
have,
them, yes.
We have no issue getting rid of those, right?
Okay.
We're doing fine there?
She is very comfortable.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're going to keep an eye on...
Keep an eye on Jabba. Maybe we'll get him off the table. It might be a little cool for him. We'll put him on
how,
his little
how
lid
How far
here.
Can they jump?
This guy is not much of a leaper. He's very heavy-bodied. He just kind of sits there. and he finds a nice chunky spot.
Frankly. Yeah.
Yes, that's
yeah.
That,
how
thus,
old is he?
Thus Jabba. He's about 4 years old.
Okay. Funny.
So how big will he get?
2.5 pounds, a little bit bigger. He's pretty much a full-grown male. But in the pet world, a lot of fun because they're pixie frogs. They're only this big when you first get them, and I love to sell them because people have to come into the store for all kinds of food all day long.
I gotta tell you, if I stumbled across this guy in the jungle somewhere, I would still be freaked out because that's a big frog.
Yeah, and the myth about frogs is that they're so nice, right? They're carnivores, right? All frogs eat meat.
Right.
All frogs eat insects. Or
oh, there we go.
Such as that.
Hey.
Just ate one.
There goes one. And, you know, if I threw a bird, a mouse, a fish, a snake, a lizard in front of him, he'd eat that. All frogs have teeth, they bite their food, and they're not as nice as you think. The nicest animal here, really,
is the
tarantula, comparatively.
Right? We have Castro here as well, right, this morning?
And then we have our boy Castro. And if you come out and see
there goes another one.
There he goes. Yeah, he does stick his tongue out a little bit. Another myth is they shoot their tongues ungodly. You know, they don't shoot them 20 feet in the air and catch flies that go by. He's not catching any flies, Jabba. He'll just sit there.
Oh, whoa. There you go, little guy.
Wait for something to fall in front of him. Today's menu, of course, is worms, but it doesn't really matter what it is. Whatever I throw down there, he will
help himself.
Whoa, two for the price of one.
I think he just burped on TV there. Oh. That's okay.
That's all right.
That's a big guy.
One more for the crowd. So he's always a crowd pleaser. We use him in all of our educational performances, and he's on display.
What do the kids say when they see this?
Well, unfortunately, all the kids don't know what Jabba the Hutt is anymore.
That's true.
As time goes on, they're losing that Jabba thing, but they just think he's amazing. And he is, you know, and it is the truth about
him. There he goes. Okay.
All right.
Well done, Jabba.
So there's Jabba. He did his thing.
Re-meet Castro if we can.
Sorry, I didn't mean to touch
you. I think we could put Castro right on the table. He sounds like he was comfortable there.
Yeah.
There's Dylan, our animal handler, who's taking care of business
today. He's pretty scary looking.
And as scary as he looks, right? Of course, he's what we call an herbivore. So he, as menacing as he is a fruit and veggie guy.
Okay. He has no teeth.
He has pretty good teeth. He takes the banana peel and all, and he chomps right through it.
Wow.
And his claim to fame, of course, he's very topical. He's a Cuban iguana. This isn't the green iguana that you see in some of the other pet stores. They really don't make the best of pets. I don't even sell them. I do nothing but reptiles. I don't sell the green ones. These are terrestrial iguanas that you'll see throughout the islands. The Cayman Islands, the Dominican Republic. Almost every island you can name has their own rock iguana.
I think it's in the Caymans they have the blue one, right?
They're blue, very good. Just look just like this.
Yeah.
But because of what happened in the Caymans, they built them up. The hotels, there's very, very few Caymans left.
Right.
The only island that's not built up yet is Cuba.
Right.
And there's plenty of Cubans, but they start putting hotels on the beaches, we'll see the end of
it.
So tell us about him. How small did he, I'm one with the animals this morning.
There you go.
Hi, do you want this? You can have it.
All right, Bob, you grew up in Manhattan.
Yeah, I was born not far from here, Hell's Kitchen,
How'd you get into these kind of animals?
Well,
you don't find these, you know, on the west side.
Yeah, I'm about as city kid as you can get. My dad was NYPD, my mom was from Brooklyn, Kosciuszko Street. We moved out to Babylon when I was a young guy, and wow, I lived next to a lake that had frogs and toads and turtles and all kinds of snake species, and I just developed a fascination for these things at that point. Now I'm up to 17 countries only, but a lot of trips to tropical forests. We take people on eco-travel tours to go looking for these things in the wild. But on a daily basis, we dispel the myths associated
with it. He's sliding off the back of the table.
He's good. He's good.
So how fast do these things go?
Oh, well, on the beach in Cuba, when it's 95 degrees out, being cold-blooded, his body warms up, he can move along pretty fast. Not so fast, and Jabba hasn't won many races in his life.
Yeah, he hasn't moved.
Yeah.
All right, Jungle Bob, people can find you. Center Reach, Long Island.
Right, smack in the middle of Long Island.
Get something on your mouth there, buddy. You got to clean up.
You're on TV, be good. Halfway to the Hamptons, you'll find Center Reach.
Good stop on the way to the beach.
A great stop because we are a destination these days. People come just to see the animals. We don't ask you to buy tarantulas when you come. We want you to get educated. And then if the bug hits you like it hit me years ago, we're the place to go for sure.
All right, Bob, thanks so much. Happy New Year to you and
thank you so much.
All these friends.
And Rosie, thank you for not being so fresh.
Yeah. All right, in the meantime, let's go over to Mike Woods.